just how I feel.
Be the last one out to get this dough. No way, love one of you bucket headed hoes. No way, hit the streets and we break the code. No way, hit the brakes when they on patrol. No way, be the last one out to get this dough. No way, love one of you bucket headed hoes. No way, hit the streets and we break the code. No way, hit the brakes when they on patrol.
I'm Danny McNabb, originally from Dallas, Texas. I started off with an Infiniti G25 when I was 16 years old. I got that car. That was my first car, actually. It was a 2012 slate blue. Never did much to it. It was a G25, so instead of the basically same body as the G37, just had the 2.5 engine instead of the 3.7, so I didn't bother doing much performance modifications or anything to that. I got the wheels powder coated black, got the windows tinted limousine tint, got the exhaust, got the muffler deleted, and that's pretty much it, just so I could hear a little bit of that noise. Fast forward, while I still had my Infiniti, me and a few buddies decided to pick up a little project car. It was a Jeep Grand Cherokee. It was an XJ with the V8 in them, and basically we picked it up for $800. It was semi-running, not much. It was backfiring a lot, basically sounded like gunshots when we started up. Put some work into it to fix it, used that as a little ranch car at my buddy's ranch to get around to do some hunting with. And after about 6 or so months, sold that for $2,500, so made about $1,500 off that one. And then when I was on a ski trip, March 2017, and I don't know what really caused me to want to do this, but I just remember I was sitting out in our little ski villa, and I was just kind of browsing Craigslist, looking at cars for sale. And I just remember always wanting a Jeep WK1 SRT8, the old 06, 07 Jeep SRT8s, with that big boxy body style. And they just held their value so well, up $20,000 still. And as you know, as a 18-year-old college student, just not something I could afford. So I went ahead and I remembered something I had seen a couple years back. It was called a Trailblazer SS. Not many of you may know about them. They're just basically your regular Trailblazer. Had a couple body modifications, different front bumper, different rear bumper, and then they came with an LS2, the same engine that the C6 Corvette had in them. And they also came in all-wheel drive, and being a student up here at the University of Arkansas in Fayetteville, I wanted something all-wheel drive for when it does snow or the occasional ice up here. So I thought, hey, what's better than a V8 grocery getter SUV? So got back from my ski trip. I was still on spring break. I actually convinced my parents that I had 2 weeks of spring break, even though I didn't. I ended up skipping a whole week of school just to go pick up this car. Drove up to Kansas City, met this guy. He trailered it up there for me. Bought the Trailblazer, had a buddy come up with me in my Infiniti. Him and I drove, he drove my Infiniti back. I drove the Trailblazer back from Kansas City, drove back to Dallas, and then literally sold the Infiniti that same day, and the next day drove up to Fayetteville, Arkansas, and came back to school, started classes back up again for spring break. And I had that Trailblazer SS for about the last 3 years, and when I first got that thing, I made a whole list of all the performance modifications that I wanted to do to it. Cam, headers, stall converter, racing seats, cage. I wanted to do it all, like I'm sure every 18-year-old when they get their first sports car wants to do. So I picked that up, made my whole list, got like at all how much it was going to cost and everything. And then next thing I know, engine blows. So this was the summer after I got it. So about 3 months after I having it, the engine blew. Not a great spectacular story or anything. I was on the service road. I rolled down my window and I just heard a loud tick, 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 tick. And somehow I was able to get it home. I spun a bearing and I brought it into the engine shop where I was going to get my LS2 rebuilt. And this was in the middle of the summer. College kid, you know, I want to get out, but at the same time, got to get the race car fixed. And it was my only car at the time too. So I took it into the shop and they had a little bit of difficulties, and it took them around 2 months to get it done, just the engine rebuild. The engine rebuild took about 2 months. Finally got the TVSS back, and it was in perfect condition. Cylinders bored out 30, which is actually the max bore for the LS2. so it had a little bit more power than stock. I went and got it street tuned because up in Fayetteville there's not many all-wheel drive dynos around. So I got it street tuned and it was running real well. Ran nice for about 6 months, and I was on my way home back to Dallas from Fayetteville, Arkansas, and I noticed the trans kind of feel a little clunkiness, feel a little slipping in it, and the check engine light came on. I pulled over, I had a little scanner on me, so I scanned it, and it was like 4 trans codes, and I immediately knew something probably wasn't right with the trans. So I was like, I have an hour. I was in Durant, Oklahoma at the time. I lived in Dallas, Texas, so I had about an hour left on my drive. And even though I shouldn't have, I was like, I gotta make it home. So I turned it back on, kept going, and I just remember getting back onto the highway, and it was just like clunking through the gears, getting back on. And the rest of the drive home, it ran fine, surprisingly. Got it home and took it to my trans builder, and the trans was pretty much torn up. Had to get the trans rebuilt. Got some upgraded parts in it, got some shift kit, stuff like that. And then that lasted about 6 months, and then I was racing a little Mustang underneath a little bypass. I had it in first gear, shifted from first to second, and blew some sort of ring or gasket, and I didn't notice for 30 seconds or so when I looked in my rearview mirror and just saw a cloud of smoke behind me for about a half mile to a mile. And I pull over, and my trailblazer, who I named Delilah, just pissed transmission fluid all over the side of the road. And I was like, great. It's already been one engine, now it's gonna be the second transmission. Thankfully, I had a warranty on it, but I had still never gotten to any of those list of modifications, which I had talked about, because I was putting in money, $4,000 for an engine, $2,000 for a transmission, fixing small things here and there, control arms, bushings, ball joints, wheel hub bearings, and I just never had the time or money to even put in performance parts and do what I really wanted to do to the car. And so I had that Trailblazer SS for about 3 years, and about a month ago, 2 months ago, I have a buddy. His name is Trey Parr, shout out Trey. He's been real cool in the Trailblazer SS community with hooking me up with parts, getting me anything I need, and he's getting a turbo kit installed on his Trailblazer SS right now. And he hit me up, he said, hey homie, I got some speed engineering headers, if you want them, just hit me up, and you know, I got you, bro. So I hit him up, got the speed engineering headers, got those on, and after 3 years, that was the first performance modification I was able to do to the Trailblazer SS. I did the speed engineering headers, got performance wires, performance plugs, and just the wire stock so the headers didn't melt the plugs or anything like that. And so yeah, after 3 years I did that, I went and got it tuned again. It ran well, it was a little too loud for my liking. And my buddy knew I'd been looking for a Chevy SS for a while. It was kind of more of something I'd planned to do next summer. Nothing I'd really even thought that was going to be something serious, especially with how few Chevy SS's are out there. But my buddy tagged me in this one right here, one day, a few weeks ago actually, mid-November 2020. And he said, hey Danny, you need to get this one, like this is the one for you. And it was posted by Texas Hot Rides, which is a dealership, which is actually like 5 minutes away from my home back in Dallas. I know they're a pretty reputable dealership. I know the owner, Mitch, and we've always gotten along well. A couple of my buddies have bought cars from them, never had any problems. So, you know, I was like, you know, I'm gonna go check it out. Still didn't really think anything was gonna happen. I still had a Trailblazer only worth, you know, maybe $8,000-$9,000. I didn't have money for something like this, but I was like, let's see what we can do. Let's see what we can make happen. And something that I really liked about this one is the price of it was about the same price as the stock one that you'd find. And it had everything pretty much that I wanted done to it done already. And I talked to the previous owner who sold it to Texas Hot Rides. It seemed like a very honest man. Unfortunately, because of coronavirus, he did fall on some hard times. And because of that, he was forced to sell this car because he needed one car that could get him around during the winter. And this just was not the car for that. So I continued and I spoke with the original owner, his name was Lewis, and he just put a miraculous amount of work into this vehicle. He treated it like a baby. I mean, I believe he was up in Missouri, but he never drove it in the snow. He had another car that he would use as his daily, and like I said, because of coronavirus, unfortunately fell on some hard times and had to get rid of it. And I saw it posted for sale on Texas Hot Rides, and it had the cam done, headers, Corsa cat-back exhaust, 3200 stall converter, adjustable coilovers, adjustable sway bars, adjustable everything in the suspension. Has these nice Regan Masters. I believe these are actually one of one for the Chevy SS. I don't think there's any other Chevy SS with this combination of Regan Masters. And I saw this car and I immediately fell in love with it. And I headed down to Dallas after actually selling my Trailblazer SS that same night. Didn't get what I wanted to sell it for. I basically gave it away dirt cheap. But I got cash for it and that's what I needed. I headed down to Dallas. I had Sunday and Monday off, so I was able to get back to Dallas on Sunday, kind of get all my paperwork in line, get all my money in line. And then I'd already put down a deposit on this car, which was a $1,000 non-refundable one-week deposit. So I knew on Saturday when I made that deposit, I had that week to sell the Trailblazer, get down to Dallas, and buy this car while juggling work, school, and selling my car. So I was able to do it somehow, made it down there. Monday morning came around, and I woke up and I was excited, but I was stressed and I was just anxious. I was like, I feel young to be getting a car like this, but at the same time, you know, I've worked a lot. I've gotten to where I am now. I'm graduating University of Arkansas, and I feel as if I deserve it. So I went ahead and I got myself this car. And when I went to the dealership, I just immediately saw it. And I didn't even want to test drive it, honestly, because I already knew I was going to buy it. I did test drive it just for the funsies of it. But once I saw it and once I heard it, I knew it was the one for me. Like I said, Lewis put some meticulous amount of work into it. Custom front grille. He had the whole interior rebadged to the Holden badging. The dash is all Holden airbag, Holden dash cluster. So when you turn it on, you see Holden and all that stuff. And so he put a lot of work into this car. I've loved it so far. Haven't lost any races yet, which I enjoy. I've been scraping a lot, which is something I don't enjoy, but overall it's been a really great car for me and I've been loving it so far.